Mantras, many people who know me must have heard me say this again and again, because it's so important for everybody in all ways. And the mantra is, Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinah, Sarve Santu Niramaya, Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu, Ma Kaschit Dukkhabhag Bhavet. I would add, Loka Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu. Now this defines the entire vision of the rishis of ancient times who have given us the Upanishads, the Vedas, the Puranas, the Devi Sutras, so many things which we cannot count actually. I must not forget to include the great rishi Patanjali, who gave us the great Yoga Sutras of Patanjali, on which research is going on for hundreds of years, and you cannot complete the research, I think, in another century, as Swami Vivekananda said, because there is so much to study. Now, when you say Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinaha, it means may the whole world be happy. Now, there are two kinds of happiness. One is connected with the ayush, of course, which is physically one has to be happy. But you should understand it has also included mental health as one of the most important parts of ayush. The WHO now has said in its mission statement that not only is health physical, but it's also to do with the mind. This year I was there in Geneva at the WHO. We had a nice meeting and the subject was yoga as a scientific discipline. There are many forms of yoga. I'm not going into the details, but yoga is one important aspect of inner inquiry of the human being, where you can systematically go step by step and experiment and find out for yourself. There is nothing unscientific out there. It's completely scientific. So, since we are on the subject, I would like to define this practice. Now, there are many yogas. The Bhagavad Gita has 18 chapters. All 18 chapters are considered to be yogas, starting with Krishna, Arjuna Vishada Yoga, and so on. Now the thing is, when you say Arjuna Vishada Yoga, it means the yoga of Arjuna's insecurity, Arjuna's sorrow, and Arjuna's uncertainty. I think it applies to all of us, because in some way we are all Arjunas, in some way. So we are standing there uncertain, not knowing where to move forward, what is the best way to adopt, and there is Sri Bhagavan Uvacha, says how to go about this matter, how to live in this world, and how to also keep yourself anchored in the inner self, which is a spark of the Supreme Being. The ancient mantra, which says Purnamada, doesn't stop there. It also says Purnamidam, which means not only is the origin, which is the Supreme Being, in its essence, Purna, complete. We also, when we manage to dissolve all our imperfections, become a spark of that Purna. So Purnamidam. Now this can happen physically, this can happen in the mind, and then when the mind is brought under control, then you go beyond to that which is one's true essence, which is there in every one of us. The other day I said something which came under severe criticism from some of my friends in Kerala. I'm originally from Kerala. You know, the political principles are a little different. I was criticized because I said that communism will not work in this world. This is not a political speech. I'm telling you why. It believes in equality. Okay. Have you found equality anywhere? It has failed in everywhere in the world. Where is this equality? I said, yes, there is one thing which Swami Vivekananda said, spiritual socialism. What did he mean by that? He said, there is one equality. If all of us have the Atman, which is a spark of the Supreme Paramatman, then in essence we are all equal. Outside we are unequal, naturally. Somebody is higher, somebody is lower, somebody is a big man, somebody is a small person, but in essence, we are the Atman. And if we are the Atman, we are a spark of the Paramatma. Therefore, we know it or we don't know it, we are all in that sense spiritually equal. We haven't found it, that's a different matter, but when you find it, you are spiritually equal. Now, this is the wonderful message of Vedanta, which has been preached. I'm going to stop now with one quotation from Swami Vivekananda. When he was asked, well, my childhood hero, I'm sure for many of you, when he was asked, can you define the essence of Vedanta? He said, very simple. Every soul is potentially divine. Okay? To manifest that divinity, either through karma or through bhakti. Bhakti is a wonderful thing. You won't go, you will have become a satsang. To manifest that divinity, either through work or through worship or through meditation or through selfless service, is the essence of Vedanta. He said everything else are fancy trimmings put on it. So with this message, that we will consider the teachings of the ancient sages. We will look into the teachings of Swami Vivekananda, who came like a lightning strike and disappeared as quickly as he had come, with this great message, which is Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinaha. I would like to conclude and thank everyone for inviting me here, including Shankara TV. Om Shanti Shanti.
ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ ವೀಕ್ಷಕರೇ, ಇದು ವಿ ಟಿವಿ ಕನ್ನಡ, ಇದು ನಿಮ್ಮದೇ ಚಾನಲ್. ದಯವಿಟ್ಟು ನಮ್ಮ ವಿಡಿಯೋಸ್ನ ಲೈಕ್ ಮಾಡಿ, ಶೇರ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಮರಿಬೇಡಿ. ಇನ್ನು ಸಬ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದರೆ ದಯವಿಟ್ಟು ಸಬ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ ಬಟನ್ ಒತ್ತಿ ಹಾಗೂ ಬೆಲ್ ಬಟನ್ ಒತ್ತಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಮರಿಬೇಡಿ. ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ.